In science fiction, whenever an asteroid is headed toward Earth, a team of scientists shows up and dramatically finds a way to destroy the asteroid or blast it away. But soon, we will see if that idea also holds up in reality. As early as November 24th, NASA will launch the Double Asteroid Redirection Test Mission, also known as DART. And it's gonna do just what the name says. It will attempt to show whether or not we could knock an asteroid off course if we really needed to. And yes, this does sound like the plot of the movie Armageddon, but it is not science fiction. If all goes well, DART will intentionally crash into an asteroid next September and change its orbit. Now, to be clear, the asteroid in question is not on a collision course with Earth. As far as we know, there are no asteroids that could cause widespread damage scheduled to hit the Earth in the next 100 years. And we do not and should not have to wait for a threat to start preparing for it. So scientists have picked out the perfect scapegoat to test DART on, a 160-meter-wide moonlet orbiting the asteroid Didymus. The moonlet is officially called Dimorphos, although some people are calling it Didymoon. What makes this moonlet such a great choice is that at the time of impact, it'll only be around 11 million kilometers from Earth. That means it'll be possible to use ground-based telescopes and radar to see what happens after DART hits it. The spacecraft has a mass of about 550 kilograms, and it will be going around 24,000 kilometers per hour when it deliberately crashes into the moonlet. But even then, scientists expect Didymoon's orbit to change by less than 1%. They estimate that it will start orbiting Didymos a whole 10 minutes faster than usual, which shows you what kind of power we would need to deflect a big asteroid. Still, this is just a test. The mission will help scientists understand how much momentum is required to alter an asteroid's orbit. And when all is said and done, we will know whether shooting a spacecraft at an asteroid to knock it off course is more science fiction or more science fact. Which, someday, might come in handy. Meanwhile, on a much larger scale, scientists recently stumbled upon a planetary system that is throwing them for a loop. So in our solar system, the planets generally orbit the sun in the same flat plane along the sun's equator. And that matches what scientists have found in a lot of other planetary systems, too. But then, there are some oddballs. Like, last month in the Journal of Astronomy and Astrophysics, researchers announced that they had found the first system with planets that have orbits roughly perpendicular to each other. The three planets in question orbit the star HD 3167 in the constellation Pisces, about 150 light-years from Earth. In 2019, scientists observed the two outermost planets orbiting the star in a weird way, traveling vertically over the star's poles instead of going horizontally around its equator. This is kind of strange, because most scientists think that planets form from a spinning disk of matter left behind after a star forms. That disk spins out from the star's equator, so it makes sense that the planets would form and orbit along the equator too. That said, planets with a polar orbit have been seen before, so this didn't, like, break physics or anything. But that's not where the story ends. In this new study, researchers pinpointed the movement of a third planet in that system as well, and it was a bit of a surprise. So this planet is the one closest to the star, close enough that it orbits once every 23 hours. The planet is also considerably smaller than the other two. But the real surprise was that it behaved like planets in our solar system. It orbited along the star's equator, which also meant it was orbiting at roughly a 90-degree angle to the other two planets in the star system. So very hypothetically, if you were standing on this innermost planet looking through binoculars at the other two, you would see them move vertically through the sky rather than traveling across it horizontally. Now the big question is, how these planets ended up that way? Now the researchers don't know for sure, but their findings suggest that there might be something out there whose gravity is tugging on the two outermost planets and pulling them into polar orbits. For example, while doing mathematical analyses for a previous study, researchers found some evidence that there could be a relatively large planet orbiting this star, or even a brown dwarf. That's sort of an in-between object bigger than a gas giant and smaller than a star. Regardless, if this fourth body exists, scientists think its gravity might have been enough to yank the outermost planets into a different orbit, but not enough to affect the innermost planet. Because that world orbits so close to its star, and at that distance, the star's gravitational pull would dominate. To figure out whether or not this other body exists, researchers are going to need to continue observing the star for any tiny movements that would happen as this other object's gravity tugs at it. And that, they say, will take some time. But in the meantime, the researchers say that this discovery reminds us that space is a lot more complicated than we might imagine. Turns out, all kinds of solar systems are possible, and ones like this might even be more common than we think. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow Space. If you would like to help support the channel, you can check out patreon.com/scishowspace. Yes, we have our own Patreon for this channel, so if you love yourself some space news, check it out.